everyone, and we're back. My name is Miss Scarlet Tanager, and I am playing some Final Fantasy X. I can't see out of my bangs again. Oh my god, of course. The second I start the video, and still can't use my bangs properly, begin to fight. As I was saying, hi guys! I'm gonna have a hard time using my controller, because I, cut my thumb open at work today. Like, not just scratched it, no, I straight up gouged the motherfucker. I think we had to use, like, 10 paper towels. No, like seven paper towels covered in my blood, because it wouldn't stop bleeding and I kept bleeding through bandages. But makes it hard to click buttons on the controller. That's why I'm playing this one and not Mass Effect at the moment, because Mass Effect requires more button clicks.
We have been expecting you, Lady Yuna. Welcome to Guado Salam.
Hi, Trommel.
This way, m'lady. This way.
Me?
It's like, excuse you, bro!
Oh, I beg your pardon.
Bro.
I am called Trommel Guado. I am in the direct service of our leader, the great Seymour Guado.
You don't just grab a lady, dude.
Seymour has very important business with Lady Yuna.
Business with me? Whatever could it be, I wonder?
Please, come inside the manor. All will be explained. Of course, your friends are also welcome.
He is so creepy in this game, you guys. Trommel is so creepy.
Twist our arms, why don't you?
Sure.
I almost forgot.
What? Oh, I don't want your tutorials, Riku.
No.
Oh, Riku. Tutorializing the fuck out of me. Okay, let's go see what the king of creepy Mother Hubbards wants. Because he's the king of creep. Absolute king of creep. So creepy. Hi, Yuna, how you doing?
Why does he want to see me?
I really don't want to answer that, because Seymour's creepy and we should all leave.
Yuna.
But I don't wanna. I wanna talk to Riku.
I wonder what smells so nice.
Seymour's creepiness.
Kimari
smells like rotten fruit.
Mr. Seymour.
Yes, I agree, Kimari. Kimari not like Seymour. And he was like, oh no, shut up, you'll hear you.
I don't like the smell of this one, eh?
What is that with smells? Riku's like, what's that smell? And Mark is like, I don't like the smell of this.
These are the past leaders of the Guado. They all look the same.
Except for Seymour.
Mr. Seymour doesn't
also,
look
that's
like
racist.
Them, no.
Don't you know? The last leader, Maester Jiskel, wed a human woman. She was Seymour's mother.
He's half human. And they can breed perfectly fine. Oh my god, Lulu, I don't care. Yuna!
Why does he want to see me?
You really don't want me to answer that. Okay, let's just go.
This way, please.
Hi, Trommel. You're just as creepy as... You get much better in 10, too. There's very few things you can say that about, but Trommel does get much better in 10, too. But holy hell, is he creepy in this one. Okay, bye. Bye, Trommel.
I will go inform Lord Seymour. Please wait here.
And eat some of the nummy food, because there's so much food on the tables. And it's the same food! Like, you see all this food here? The same food is on the tables in 10-2. The same plates are there, the same all of the food is there in 10-2. It's like, is it just immortal fruit or something? It just never rots? Yuna!
What could it be? Oh...
Stop getting so excited! You're really not gonna like it. At least you eventually really aren't gonna like it.
This is good!
Riku! Have you ever heard of Persephone?
There's no temple here in Guado Salam, see? Summoners usually just pass through on their way elsewhere. What?
I didn't even ask a question and you're explaining things.
You'd rather I say nothing, then?
No. Maybe you finally believe I don't know anything about Spira. And maybe that means you believe me about Xanarkin, too?
Well, there are many things I do not know.
That's not an answer, Lulu!
Xanarkin is one of those things. I suppose I can't say what I think, either way.
Sure you can!
Still, be careful. You shouldn't tell other people.
Yeah, I know.
Other people. Seymour! Orin!
Stay on your guard.
Well, yes!
Why? This guy is just a priest, right?
Those with power use that power. Maesters have power.
Wait. You sure you don't have something against Yevon?
Oh, yes he does!
I lived a long time in Zanarkand.
Ah.
I lived a long time. That's not an answer. It's like he answered one thing with a completely different something else.
I get the feeling he called us up here for more than just dinner.
Time for bad time. Stare at the pretty spheres. Useless zoom up is useless. Just gotta zoom in on Titus's pecs.
Truly, it is good to have guests again.
Hey, Dremel.
Since Lord Giskel passed away, these halls have been too quiet.
The death of Lord Giskel was a great loss for all of Spira.
Was this Maester Giskel really such a great guy?
He brought the teachings of Yevon to the Guado. He was truly a great man.
Truly a
loss for
us
all. And then he died.
But now a new leader, Lord Seymour, has come before us. Lord Seymour is the child of a Guado and a human. He will be the tie that binds our two races together. But that is not all, I think. Lord Seymour, he will surely become the shining star that lights the way for all the peoples of Spira.
That is enough.
He's too much of a slimy git for that.
Must I always endure such praise?
Creeper alert!
Welcome!
You...
Welcome, I barely trust you.
Please, make yourselves at home. There's no rush.
There is a rush,
bro. Please keep this short. Yuna must rush.
Pardon me. It has been a long time since I had guests. Lady Yuna, this way.
And then suddenly, pretty space lights. He's trying so hardcore to woo Yuna, it's just... But he's so sleazy and creepy.
This
Get away from her.
Is a reconstruction created from the thoughts of the dead that wander the far.
Stop creeping, Seymour! Titus, what did Orin say? Stay close to Yuna. You are on the opposite side of group Yuna, who is currently getting too close to Seymour. You should get between the two.
Correct. Zanarkand, as it looked 1,000 years ago.
Hey, Titus, is it a good rendition? Is it good copy?
The great and wondrous Machina city, Zanarkand. She once lived in this metropolis.
Orin sees right through your shit, Seymour. Seymour! Orin sees right through your bullshit. He sees right through it. Everybody else may be slightly oblivious, except maybe Kimari and a little bit of Titus. But oh dear. Hi,
Lady
Yuna Luska. I'm going to hate you later.
She's the first person to defeat sin and save the world from its ravages. And you have inherited her name.
It was my father who named me.
Lord Braska was entrusting you with a great task. He wanted you to face sin as Lady Yuna Luska did. However, Lady Yuna Luska did not save the world alone. To defeat the undefeatable sin, it took an unbreakable bond of love, of the kind that binds two hearts for eternity.
Most drawn-out wedding proposal ever. Marriage proposal. Nice armor there, bro! Looks kinda Warrior of Light from Final Fantasy Dissidia. Gotta keep him in base in my head. Reaper alert. I'm surprised Yuna's not beat Red, and, like, she's probably catching on at about this point to, like, oh my god, he's about to propose to me, holy shit. And for some reason, nobody else can hear the proposal from there! Even though they're all, like, in the same room. He's like, I'm going to molest you now. Oh, no, not here, Mr. Seymour! I don't know why Yuna's suddenly a Mickey Mouse. Oh! Oh! I can't do a Mickey Mouse voice for shit. Oh, you're a creepy, creepy man. And then... freak out. Downs an entire glass of water. Yeah, they didn't feel the need to animate her beat red face, because she... If a stranger just proposed to me, I would at least turn a little
wow,
bit red.
Your face is beat red.
No, it's not.
You okay?
Yeah, her face is not red at all. Don't know what you guys are talking about. She's in fact quite pale.
He asked me to marry him.
You serious?
I was like, wait, what?
Hey!
Seymour, what the fuck?
You know what Yuna must do.
Of course. Lady Yuna, no, all summoners, are charged with bringing peace to Spira. But this means more than just defeating sin. She must ease the suffering of all Spira.
Oh, shut up, Seymour.
She must be a leader for the people.
Stop your worm tongue poisoning word
Yuna
shit.
As a maester of Yevon.
Spira is no playhouse. A moment's diversion may amuse an audience, but it changes nothing.
Even so, the actors must play their parts. There's no need to answer right away. Please, think it over.
We will do so then.
Lady Yuna, I await your favorable reply.
I love how Orin's always in charge. It's Yuna's pilgrimage, but Orin's always in charge. Like, nobody wants to tell Orin now.
Why are you still here, sir? I beg your pardon. We Guado are keen to the scent of the Far Plane.
Ha ha ha! He just sniffs Orin! I love how that didn't trip, like, anybody else's mind. It's supposed to make the player go, wait a minute, what's wrong with Orin? But none of the other characters have any reaction to that line except for Tidus. Like, and he just sniffs him, like, what the fuck are you talking about? Everybody else should have gone, wait, sent to the Far Plane? Wait, holy shit, is Orin unsent? Nobody does anything. Oh, getting out of here now because Tidus.
Yuna, the High Summoner's daughter. Seymour, the leader of the Guado. Married in the name of Yevon. Overcoming the barriers of race. It would give Spira something cheery to talk about for a change.
Sounds just like a passing daydream, like Auron says.
I'm with Walk on this
one. Let's just get on with the pilgrimage. I mean, marriage?
Jealous?
Yes.
What? No way.
Yes,
Tidus,
come on. We
gotta defeat sin. Romance can wait.
No, it can't.
You sure picked a fine time to lay this one on us.
Yep.
Maybe it is a fine time.
You serious?
If my getting married would help Spira, if it would make people happy, if I could do that for people, maybe I should do what I can. I never imagined doing anything like this.
Yeah, about
but
that.
I won't answer till I know what's right.
Seriously?
You could always just quit your pilgrimage and get married.
Riku!
I will go on. I'm sure that Lord Seymour will understand.
I guess so.
I am a summoner. I must fight and defeat sin.
Like Braska before you.
I had to stop myself from shouting. What's there to think about?
I'm going to the Far Plane. I'm going to see my father and think on this.
Go on. We'll be right behind you.
I wondered why none of the others ever asked Yuna. Do you love Seymour? Do you even like him?
Tidus has been quiet this so... Like, if I was in Tidus' situation, I would have yelled a long time ago, like, why are you all so fatalistic about this pilgrimage? What the hell happens at the end? Like, what's involved in the final summoning? Like, I would have figured out the big secret a long time ago. Or I would have gotten one of them to tell me because I never would have stopped asking questions, and, like, there. Where he's like, I really wanted to ask them, why they never asked Yuna, do you like him? Do you love him? Blah, blah, blah. But I would have been just... Tidus is dumb. Everybody else is dumb.
If somebody dies, a summoner sends them to the Far Plane, right? So their souls, or whatever they are, they go to the Far Plane, right?
Mm-hmm.
But that's the Far Plane we're going to, right?
Yep.
And Yuna's old man's there too?
Yep.
Do dead people live there or something?
Yep. Sort of. Nobody answers them. Dead fiends. Gonna go
you're
see all the fiends.
Thinking those funny thoughts again, yeah?
Yep. That's exactly what he's thinking.
You'll see once we get there.
I have a burn on my wrist from work. See, I cut my thumb open, but I also burned my wrist. And now it looks like I have a crescent moon on my wrist. You guys probably aren't going to be able to see it for crap. But, yeah, it was itching. But I can't scratch it because it's a burn! You can't scratch burns, that's bad!
Aren't you coming?
I do not belong there.
Yet?
Mm-hmm. You're scared.
Searching the past to find the future. This is all that is there. I need it not. You'd better be going.
You're not really going to see the dead. More like your memories of them. People think of their relatives, and the Pyreflies react to them. They take on the form of the dead person. An illusion, nothing else. Well, have fun.
What? You're not going either, Riku?
Nope.
I keep my memories inside.
Huh?
Memories are nice, but that's all they are.
And then Waka just repeats those words later.
See you later.
Okay, bye, Riku!
See you later.
Bye, Riku! Let's go to the Far Plane. Another reason why, Orin doesn't want to go there. He's like, if I cross into the weird Far Plane-y bubble, I'd disappear. Dude. Don't poke it. Just go. He's like, oh my god, I fell into the thing. But really, it's just another place. That looks nothing like Tidus. And they're like, oh, he looks so much like, or Tidus looks so much like Chapu, they look nothing alike.
What the?
Uh-oh. Hi, Yuna. Yuna and his parents. That's terrifying. That is less terrifying. Why is nobody colonized the Far Plane yet? It looks like there's so much fertile land there. Seriously, that's the Far Plane. That's fucking gorgeous, and there's so much fertile land. There would have been so many farms there. A couple settlements. All kinds of fun stuff.
The Far Plane was cool. But I couldn't stop thinking about Yuna. Her parents, they look so happy together. But it got me worried that maybe seeing them would make Yuna really consider Seymour's proposal.
Especially because Braska's dressed in like these big flowing robes like Seymour is. Hi, Yuna. Honey. Let me talk to her! I'm going to just run into her face and... Fine! Lulu!
Why don't you try calling someone? All you have to do is think about them.
I don't wanna. We're gonna talk about it.
Yo, Chapu! Meant to come see you earlier, yeah?
So doesn't look like Tita.
Sorry. I know you won't hold it against me. I gave up that game. I'm a guardian from here on, you know? This guy looks a lot like you. Showed up. Traveling with him, I thought.
No, he doesn't.
Maybe you were still alive somewhere, yeah? But then again,
why does he have a gaping open mouth?
On a far plane. Guess your place is here. So, how you been?
He can't answer you.
That guy I just told you about, I gave him your sword.
Yeah, and Tidus has it unsheathed for some reason right now. Because, you know, just walking around with the sword in hand, just whipping your sword out. Hi, Yuna.
So, Yuna?
I've decided.
Really? That's good.
I remember when I was only 7 years old in Bavel that day. My father had defeated Sin, and the whole town was out in the streets. Everyone was laughing. They all seemed so happy. If I defeated Sin, that would make everyone happy, wouldn't it? I must do what everyone wants, not just what I want.
Let's go back. You gotta tell Seymour.
Before that, call Sir Jet. Give it a try.
Huh?
Don't worry. He won't come.
Trying not to think about my old man made me think about him, of course.
Of course.
See, told you.
He isn't here because he's not dead. He's Sin.
That means he's alive, you know.
What if my old man really
yeah,
is Sin?
He already knew that.
What would I say to Yuna? Heck, to everybody in Spira. Wait, why should I have to apologize for him anyway? I'd rather never
see him again. Or maybe you could think, wait, how did my dad
what
become Sin?
What makes you hate him so?
Like, Tidus, you're so dumb. Why don't you think of these things?
Mad. It was his fault that me and my mother...
And then Mommy shows up.
Mom? It's her.
Aww.
She's very pretty.
He starts crying.
But, wait. No one ever performed the sending for her.
She must have accepted death while she was still alive.
Whoa there. That's my mother you're talking about.
Oh,
Tidus is like,
I'm
hey,
sorry.
Yuna, calm.
It's okay. I think I just figured something out.
What?
Why I hate my old man.
Because he took your mommy away from you. Because she died of a broken heart like
See,
Padme.
So I told him what I thought of him right there.
What? Really?
Of course.
I suppose, but... Mommy! Just a sec, dear.
Whenever my old man was around, my mother wouldn't even look at me. Maybe that's when I started
to
resent him.
So your mom was a bad mom.
Even hate him. When he left us, Mom just lost her energy.
Is she all right?
Tidus is
well,
up
you can.
If she dies, I wouldn't know what to do.
Don't say Mom is gonna die.
I apologize.
Wait, that's Orin, isn't it? That's young Orin voice.
The old lady next door.
That's young Orin voice. Hi, Orin.
When a lovebird dies, the one left behind, it just gives up living.
Oh, I
so
just realized.
Its mate.
I just realized the subtext
like
of that little interaction.
I hated my old man even more.
Orin went to Zarakin
really,
in order to fulfill his promise to Jax.
Mommy! Just a sec, dear.
Go to
and he has no idea how to deal with children,
don't.
so he's like, if your mother dies, I'll have no idea how to raise you. And then Mommy dies,
oh,
and Orin raised Tidus. I just figured
I must
that
sound
out.
So stupid.
I don't think so.
How embarrassing.
Well, need some more time.
No. I'm ready.
Did I miss something?
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it, Lulu. Where'd you get an apple from?
Thanks for waiting. I'll go give
also,
my answer.
Also, that is a gigantic apple. Huge apple, it's huge. Uh-oh.
Lord Jisco.
Yes, the other person already said his name, but we know
here.
Who this is.
Why?
Yuna, send him.
Nobody hears that. Jisco. Nobody checks on Orin. Nobody goes,
Lord
what the
Jisco
hell's wrong
no
with
more.
You?
Send him now.
See, he's got fireflies around him. How does nobody, like, see this or realize that the freaking Orin's on set? You can see fireflies around him. Oh, oblivious, stupid Final Fantasy characters.
Talk later. We leave
it
now.
He literally has fireflies. Yeah, literally had fireflies around him there.
What was that just now? That really Lord Jisco?
Yep.
I don't understand how a man like Lord Jisco can die and not be sent.
I would think that he was sent once, but he stayed on
Spira. But he was murdered and he got angry.
Something, a powerful emotion, could have bound him to this world. Such things happen.
That's against the rules, isn't it?
It means he died an unclean death.
He was murdered by creepy people! We'll see in a bit. Okay. Let's go to Macarania. Hey guys, what's up?
I will go meet with Maester Seymour.
Yuna! Jisco is the Guado's problem, not yours.
But Yuna's Yuna, and Yuna wants to fix everybody's problems. My God, she reminds me of my best friend.
So, Lulu, what do you think about Yuna getting married?
As long
as we're going to talk to Lulu.
Continues, either way's fine.
That's it? What if she doesn't even like the guy? Is that okay?
People marry for many reasons.
What's that mean?
Arranged marriages.
Sometimes marriage doesn't require love, you know? Defeat sin and bring joy to the people of Spira. Get married and bring joy to the people of Spira. For Yuna, they're just two ways down the same road. All you need is determination. If you have that, you don't need love.
I don't know.
That's a shitty way of looking
just
at things,
don't get
Lou.
It.
You would if anybody would actually tell you what happens at the end of a pilgrimage. Huh? Riku! Final talk
Listen,
to Lulu. Lulu!
If Yuna gets married, then I...
What? That again?
Yes. If she is to marry, I would want her to marry for love.
See?
But if Yuna said she wanted to marry the one she loves, I would have to object.
Huh? You're not making much sense.
I know.
It's like, it would make much more sense if anybody explained anything to Tidus instead of just
Lulu,
pretending like nothing was
I've
wrong.
I've talked enough about that.
What?
I'm sorry,
not
just
helping.
Forget about it.
Jeez, Grumpy.
You'll understand one of these days. I just don't want
He'd
to
understand
give it
words, now if you told
yet.
Him.
I shouldn't have to say this.
That's the one thing.
But don't fall in love with her.
You're more my type.
I see.
Though. Too late.
But you must keep your feelings inside until the pilgrimage is over.
Also, Lulu, if you're telling him to keep his feelings inside until the pilgrimage is over, you're a jerk. Because that would hurt him more.
We leave as soon as Yuna returns. I trust you'll be ready.
Yeah, sure.
For a while there, I was a little worried about what was gonna happen, yeah?
Yeah! Where's the thing? Riku! Riku! Where's Riku? There you go.
Here,
there she is.
We have to go through the thunder plains next, you know. I can't stand thunder.
What about lightning? It's very, very frightening. Let me know the thing. Leave him without Yuna.
My, was the lady summoning
Shalinda
with you?
No, she's at Seymour's place.
That's Maester Seymour, or Lord Seymour.
Oh, I'll be careful.
Or Creeper.
Sorry.
That's all right.
I like Creeper.
Oh, Maester Seymour left Guado Salam a short while ago.
You serious?
I believe he went to the temple
in like
Lachalania.
The 5 minutes they were at the far place.
Maester Seymour is also the high priest of that temple.
Whoa, I gotta tell the others.
Guys, Seymour ain't even here, bruh. And everybody's conveniently grouped up in a straight line. Well, relatively straight.
Lord Jiskill, please tell me. What can I do to help?
Yuna!
Making everybody else's problems your own again, Yuna. Oh, Yuna.
This is Seymour went to Macarena Temple.
Foolish, Yuna.
Macarena
Temple!
I?
What I don't get is, why would the Lord Maester head off without a peep to anyone?
Maybe he wasn't expecting Yuna's answer so soon.
Ah, that's probably it.
Yuna, what is it?
Oh, nothing.
You're a poor liar.
It's true, it's nothing.
Yep.
Come on, let's go.
You're lying through your teeth, beauty. You're about to do a whole bunch of really stupid things. Like, seriously. She is about to just a series of dumb decisions. That's all the next, like, yeah, 5 or 6 episodes are gonna be. Just a series of stupid decisions.
Oh,
this
no.
is this entire arc
We're
of the game
here.
Is the series the instead of a series of unfortunate events. It's series of stupid decisions.
See the lightning rod towers? The lightning is drawn to them, hopefully.
We head north.
I am not dodging 200 lightning bolts on the let's play.
Meaning we should
avoid
wide open areas.
I think I forgot something in Guado Salam.
Nice knowing you.
Okay, bye-bye, Riku.
I'll go.
Blah, blah, blah. You can dodge the lightning strikes. I know this because we need to dodge 200 of them to get Lulu's ultimate weapon. Which is the reason why Lulu's not usually in my, ideal party. Because everybody else in my ideal party, Tidus, Yuna, and Riku, much easier to get their ultimate weapons and much easier to get them fully upgraded. Except one part of Tidus's is a little bit more difficult. Constantly mashing X, however, can be dangerous. Okay. Good luck on your journey. Jeebus. Okay. I want the chesticle! Yay! I got a chesticle. And I'm getting hit by lightning because I don't care about dodging. Bah!
Well, hello there. Would you like to hear about
Hey, guys! Machin story time!
Very well. Let me tell you about the crossing. A long time
when everybody
ago,
is
this
bored
place
to death.
Was a traveler's nightmare. Plains
it's
of
not
lightning,
now.
Plains of thunder. Those who cross are torn asunder. Or so they used to say.
Nice rhyming, bro.
Then
oh, hey,
the
Shalinda's
man by
here.
The name of Bilgen appeared. Using Machina, he built towers that served as lightning rods across the plains. Finally, travelers were able to cross in safety. Bilgen was building that tower over there.
So Machina good!
When he was struck
Except
and killed
not,
by lightning.
Well, that's ironic. Okay, bye, Majin! Let's go see Shalinda. Oh, God.
Okay, hi, Shalinda. How you doing? It took two random battles to get there.
Hi there.
Is it true? I heard that Maester Seymour and Lady Yuna are to be wed.
It's
such great news. I have to tell everyone.
Don't tell anyone.
Where'd you hear that?
From the Guado. They were all very excited.
Of course they were.
I'm afraid you heard a little wrong. Yuna's gonna turn him down.
She never said that.
Oh,
I mean, she was going to, but... Yep, no wedding.
I see. That's unfortunate. Well, I'm sure that people would have rejoiced all over Spira.
Yeah, sure. How about Yuna doesn't marry anybody? Except maybe Tidus, because you know that's gonna happen. Oh! Cutscene!
Whoa!
It only took about 4 or 5 random battles to get there.
That was a close one.
Stop kidding around.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, you're not helping, Waka. Yes, ma'am. Uh-oh.
What's wrong?
Riku's lost it.
You're giving me the creeps.
She's becoming one with the lightning. Wait for it. Even Orin's like, what the fuck?
Hey, whoa!
I wanna go home! I hate lightning! I hate thunder!
Well, you're the one who decided to come with!
Please?
This storm never stops. Better to cross quickly.
Orin's got a point there.
But just for a little while?
Well, what now?
Yeah, it's like she's clinging to my foot, guys! Yuna's like, yes, I have to watch this. Totally not a...
Just a few minutes.
Totally not a sphere I got. I gotta go watch it.
I'm scared of lightning. Let's rest, please.
Even Yuna's not having any of her shit. They're just leaving her.
I'm too young to die.
Get right, Riku.
You're mean. Cruel. Your moms would be ashamed of you.
Everybody's just laughing.
Are you having fun doing this to me?
Yes.
Fine. We rest. She's worse than
the storm. I've never actually done that before, because usually I talk to Riku, and I think if you talk to Riku, she doesn't,
I'm...
Like, they don't keep going onwards, but... Still.
Do you have a room available?
Ah, Lady Summoner. Yes, just over that way.
Thank you.
Suddenly Yuna's tired and they're like, okay, we can stay now. Nope, Yuna wants to... Yuna wants to watch a certain, sphere all on her own. I wonder what could be on it. Yeah, I'll do this later. Yes, turn it on you. Orin!
What? It's not easy being a guardian to a summoner so young.
I'm not sure if that was a... making fun of Yuna moments, or original copy of History of Summoners? Oh god. Reading! Yuna!
What?
As punishment for my deeds. Whoever what? And his mother, whoever is...
Uh-oh. He's like, I'ma look through the keyhole, and get in so much trouble for everyone else. Hi, Yuna!
Yes?
I am...
Jiskel Sphere! Jiskel Sphere!
Well... It's nothing really.
You're so bad at covering. So bad at covering, Tidus.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have come in.
You did it. You fell through the doorway.
Hey, wasn't that Jiskel Guado guy?
Yep. Don't tell anyone because Yuna has to do everything on her own because she's an idiot.
The sphere is his will. It says, take care of my son.
Yeah, it means take care, like, shake him in the back. He's a, which should do.
His son? Seymour?
Because he's a creeper.
Well, I know one way to take care of him.
Shake him in the back!
I'm sorry.
Yuna, you left behind the sphere. Hi, Maka!
What do you think you're up to?
Nookie time.
Yuna was acting funny.
Yeah. She'll tell us when she's ready, so hold your chocobos till then. Yeah.
All right.
Or, you know, the sphere is right there. You both could watch and figure out that Yuna has a terrible plan in mind. Because she's terrible. She's just generally terrible. Okay,
if it's okay with Riku, shall we go?
Getting the fuck out of here, Riku.
It's not stopping, is it?
No.
Don't tell me you were hoping it would. Fine, stay here.
Or it's like, I'm done with your shit. Leave
it. Already. But you didn't have to say it like that, you know.
Hey, you're the one holding people up, Riku.
You could be more comforting or something.
This is Orin we're talking
about,
Riku.
Try to cheer me up.
Again, this is Orin we're talking about.
You just don't get me at all, do you?
No, I'm pretty sure he does.
Hey, are you listening?
He just doesn't care. Because it's Orin, he don't care about nothing.
I'm not scared.
Except his convoluted story.
I'm not scared, you hear?
Yes, you are. You're terrified. You are very terrified. You're also crazy. Uh-oh. Once! Hi, Wants. Bye, Wants! Runaway Wants Photography. He didn't even ask! I'd chase his ass down, grab that camera, and smash it if he did that to me. Like, you do not take a picture of somebody without asking. Oh, hey, I got the yellow shield. I would literally know why. Give that to Reek? Oh, that's not Reekus? Then whose was it? Oh. I thought the yellow shield was Riku's. Yellow shield. Oh, it's Tidus's. Okay. Oh, it's lightning proof. That's, I like that. I mean, I like defense, but lightning proof is pretty good too. So let's keep going, I guess. So I was doing some sphere grid stuff and I noticed something. Look at the characters' faces. You know, you see Orin, he's got his little ponytail and he's got his jacket there. Yuna doesn't look like she's wearing any clothes because you can't see, like, the white part of her top around her neck. So Yuna's naked. Lulu, probably clothed, you can't really tell, it's only from the bottom neck up, and she has the off-the-shoulder thing, so she may be clothed. Kamari, it's Kamari. Waka, could also still be clothed, but Riku, not wearing a top either. So Yuna and Riku are definitely not wearing tops, at least not the top you see in-game in their little sprite pictures. Just some things I notice, because I notice weird things and I play video games, because, I'm weird. And cutscene time, and it only took me about 6 or 7 random battles to get there.
Everywhere.
Seriously.
Wait.
It takes like 2 hours to record a 1 hour episode.
I have something to tell you.
Here?
We're almost out of here! Let's go!
I have to say it now.
No, you don't! But you're going to.
Over there.
Because you're literally the leader, even though Orin's the one who's telling everyone what to do. And here's terrible decision number one of the many terrible decisions that are going to be made the next few episodes. Enjoy.
Somehow, my bad feelings always come true.
Yep!
I've decided to marry. I thought
and
so.
My words don't match my lips at all. Terrible idea!
But why? Why'd you change your mind?
She never told you yes or no.
For Spira's future and Yevon's unity. I thought it would be the best thing to do.
That's not good enough.
Yuna?
Wait, is it? Is it because of Lord Jiskal?
Hey, that's fear.
Show me.
I can't.
Yuna!
I must speak to Maester Seymour first. I truly am sorry, but this is... it is a personal matter.
You're kidding, huh?
Pulling the rule book out on him.
As you wish.
I'm sorry.
Just one thing.
I won't quit my pilgrimage.
Then it is fine.
This is a terrible
Wait a minute,
idea.
Lauren. You don't care? I mean, you're not gonna stop her?
No, I'm not. As long as she is willing to face Sin, all else is her concern. That is a summoner's privilege, as long as she journeys.
Because in the end, spoilers for Lizzie.
But
everybody knows what happens in the end. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
Oh, we know you love her, Tidus. Stop whinging.
Yuna, just one question. Can't you just talk to Maester Seymour? You got to marry him?
Waka makes a lot of sense here,
Don't
you know.
But I think it is the right thing to do.
Okay, I guess.
Yuna, you're so dumb.
Yuni.
So dumb. I've known you for about 30 minutes of game
what?
Time. Don't you quiet me, Riku.
I wish we could help somehow. Some way.
We can, but she's being so pig-headed and not letting you. Cause
it's
she's...
okay. I'll be fine.
Dumb.
She you... says I'm sorry. He says it's fine. She's willing to face Sin. She's privileged. I didn't understand.
Yeah, and you
didn't
ask!
I felt like I didn't belong. But if I didn't belong with them, I'd be stuck in Spira, alone.
Like, I'm not the only person who feels this, right? Tidus a long
alone
time
in that
ago.
Place, well, I didn't want to think about it.
Tidus a long time ago should have gone.
To Makalania Temple.
What are you guys meeting about privilege and shit?
Seymour there. We Guardians will wait until they're done, and plan our next move. Understood?
Yeah, sure. Also, Orin is still in charge, because you can't tell Orin go. And we are finally in Makalania. That took another, like, 3 or 4 random battles. The encounter rate is so high in this game, I'd forgotten. I mean, I guess it gives my throat time to rest during a Let's Play recording, but still. And Yuna's just like, nope, gone. Nobody cares about your fear, Riku! Orin's like, I need to talk to you, boy. We need to have a discussion.
You're worried about Yuna.
Is it that
obvious?
Of course
I'm worried about her. What is she thinking?
She's not thinking, that's the problem.
In exchange for agreeing to marry him, she hopes to negotiate with Seymour.
Negotiate what?
Whatever she saw in the sphere.
What? All by herself?
Yes, because she's dumb.
She's strong, but Seymour is the better negotiator.
Well, then, why don't we do something about it?
Yeah.
Yuna wants it this way.
Because Yuna's, you know, not the brightest.
I just don't get it. Doesn't she trust us?
Nope.
On the contrary. She doesn't want us caught up in whatever it is she's planning.
We're with her, we're
yeah,
already caught
that's
up
That's what
us.
I thought.
It's not like...
But that makes me worry even more.
Like, Yuna gets us communicated, the
she
rest of them are screwed
us.
Too.
That's the way she is. She's naive. Serious to a fault, and doesn't ask for help.
Yep. All of which are very bad flaws.
You're probably right.
Yuna's easy to read.
Yeah, she is.
But hard to guard.
Yeah, because she doesn't ask for help. She doesn't ask for help. She's like, no, I can do it all on my own. And she's super, super naive, and thinks everything will be fine in the end. A.K.A. she's not the brightest.
Slowpokes!
Sorry.
We were having boy time, okay, Riku?
It's funny how calm I was. Maybe it was because I'd realized that Yuna wasn't marrying Seymour for love. Not really. It was just her duty. Something she had to do before returning to her pilgrimage. That's what I kept telling myself anyway.
And you're not like, wait a minute.
I realized that Yuna and I'd never, you know.
You can just say it.
Let's go.
You can just say it. You can just say, I'd realize that Yuna and I will never make the Beast the Two-Backs / kiss. That happens later, but whatever. Temple of Yevon Makalania, let's go get ourselves a Shiva. In the next video. Actually, nah, I got time. We'll go on for a little bit more. I mean, I could stop it now, but I kinda wanna do the part that's coming up too. Like, go through Makalania. That's gonna take me a half an hour full of random battles, because we don't have the little shortcut through Makalania yet. All the way to the end. Because at the end is, boss fight. It's always a boss fight. Oh! Cutscene! After two or three random battles. Hey, Bartello!
Have you seen Donna?
Nope! You lost her, didn't you?
Can't say I have.
What's up?
Donna got Donna napped!
We got separated on the way here. Damn it all! I've gotta find her!
Calm down.
Donna got Donna napped by the Albed!
If anything happens to her...
Running around in a panic is not going to help.
Warren has a point there, like he usually does.
Right now, you have to keep cool and search.
But!
Guard your emotions.
But I don't want to keep cool!
Then guard your summoner.
He says to Tidus.
You're right.
Shall we search?
No, I've taken up enough of your time.
Okay, if you're really that worried about Donnie, you'd be like, yes, help me search. But then, no, I don't want to take up your time. She could be dead. And or actively dying. I mean, we know what happened to her, but...
Oh, I just wanted to wish him good luck.
Or say, by the way, she's on Beacon Hill Island at this point. But, you know, we'll find that out soon enough. Oh? Another cutscene, not too long after the first one, but I still had a random battle between them. Oh, random battles. I'm never sure whether to love you or hate you. Also, butterflies. We're gonna have to deal with a lot of butterflies when we get Kimari's ultimate
weapon. A butterfly
weapon.
With rainbow wings will lead the way to secret things.
You sound so much different than the ones in Tentu. And I'm more used to the ones in Tentu since I played that game more recently. Because I've been playing through it again on this version. Oh, gosh darn it. I've been playing through 10-2 again
Everyone,
on this version because I want to get...
Enemy.
Shut up, Lulu. I want to get a 100% completed file if I ever decide to Let's Play it. That way I don't have to do everything to get the perfect ending on the Let's Play. Because I will have already done it. Okay, you guys, I got to the end of Makalania. That took a long time before I'm in the battle.
It is here. Somewhere.
Warren's being cryptic again.
What's here?
Something you should see.
But...
Jack's porn
Sir
stash.
Sir Orin.
I mean, what?
It won't take long.
Just let me cut through this gigantic tree in a single hit. Cause I'm a badass. You should see memories of Braska. Because sin is checked. Also, where'd everybody else go? I just see Orin, Tidus, and Yuna there. Like, everybody else just walked off somewhere. It's fine. Don't worry about it. Just these three. They're the only ones that are important right now. Nobody else cares about the rest of them.
This place.
Okay.
It's just water, isn't it?
This is what spheres are made
of. More than that.
No it absorbs one. And preserves people's memories.
Like pyreflies. That's why there's pyreflies. all over Makawaka.
What's that?
Also, boss fight. Oh, hey, suddenly Waka showed up. Oh, hey, there's Lulu. Where's Kamari?
Also, Yuna vanished.
It's like the characters are only there when the plot demands it. They vanish and cease to exist otherwise.
Okay, that didn't take too long, mostly because I know how to play this. I just hit the microphone. I apologize for that. So, yeah. Easy boss fight was easy peasy. I didn't even use my overdrives because we're going to need to save those. Because pretty soon it's going to be boss fight, boss fight, boss fight. I'm not even joking. It's literally boss fight, boss fight, boss fight. Jexphere! We got ourselves a Jexphere. Right. And everybody gets stuff that I'm going to have to level up.
Whoa, this is old. Don't know if you can play it back.
Jekt left it here 10 years ago. Play it back.
Mm-hmm.
Gasp, gasp. Gaps, gasp, bitty gasp.
What are you taking?
Everything.
Well, you said it was going to be a long trip. We'll be seeing a lot of neat things, right? So I thought I'd record it all in this. To show
where'd
to my
you get
wife
the money for
kid,
it?
You know.
This is no pleasure cruise.
Hey, Brasco. Ain't this supposed to be a grand occasion? We're the cheering fans, the crying women.
This is it. Too many goodbyes. People think twice about leaving.
If you say so. Well, it better be a lot more colorful when we come back.
They didn't tell Jekt either, did they?
Vanquisher of sin.
They didn't tell Jekt until the end, didn't they? Oh boy.
We should go. Day will break soon.
It looks pretty light there already. I mean.
Auron, could you stand closer to him?
Braska's totally into this recording business. I love it. And Orange is like, gosh darn it, Appa.
That should do it.
What's the matter? Afraid I might bite?
Well, Jekt. You will. We know that.
Braska, you should take one too. It'll make a great gift for little Yuna.
Aww.
I suppose.
Lord, why did you nod with the camera?
We shouldn't be wasting our time like this.
Orange, shut
up! Hurry, man.
Let me tell you what the hurry is.
I love how Orange's been wearing the same thing since he was, like, whatever age he was when he and Braska. Oh, wait, it was 10 years ago. Whatever age is.
He wasn't on some pleasure cruise.
He's been wearing the same thing for 10 years.
I think there's more.
I think there's more, it's just pretty nice.
Hey.
Sup?
If you're sitting there watching this, it means you're stuck in Spira like me. You might not know when you'll get back home, but you better not be crying.
Jekt!
Although I guess I'd understand. But you know what? There's a time when you have to stop crying and move on. You'll be fine. Remember, you're my son. And, well, never mind, I'm no good at these things.
You're no good at being a dad, either. No, seriously, Jekt is a terrible father. He's a great dude, he's a great guy, but...
I believe in you. Be good.
Okay, he might be an okay father at times, but other times not so much. Like, calling your kid a crybaby... It's kind of a jerk thing to do.
He sounded almost serious, but it was too late.
Yep.
He was serious. Jekt had already accepted his fate.
His fate?
Dun, dun, dun.
Jekt, he...
Became
Sin. He was always talking about going home to Xanarkand. That's why he took all those pictures, to show them to you when he returned. But as he journeyed with us, and came to understand Spira and Braska's resolve. It happened gradually, but Jekt changed. He decided he would join Braska in his fight against Sin.
So then, he gave up going home?
Yep.
That
and you saw what happened
was
to him.
His decision.
I guess I understood. My old man. He knew there was no way back home. Back to Xanarkand. He wanted to go home, but he knew he couldn't. He couldn't go on until he accepted it. Besides, even if he had found a way back, I don't think he would have left his friends behind before their journey was complete.
All right, let's go, guys.
Maybe I had to start accepting my own fate.
Tidus, why haven't you asked Orin how he got to Xanarkand then? Like, it's established that Orin has gone to Xanarkand and returned to Spira at least a couple times. So, like, I mean, how? I know how because I've played this game and I know these things, but Tidus has never asked that question. Which seems kind of silly on his part. But either way, you guys, that's gonna be it for this video. Oh, hi! Never mind.
Yeah?
Nothing. Yes, Orin.
Loved you.
Orin, don't
come
start.
On, please.
He just didn't know how to express it, he said.
Enough about my old man, okay?
Still doesn't get bothered to
hear
though, Orin.
Yeah, okay.
I still hate him.
Thanks.
No. It's like the most complicated father-son relationship. It's almost like my relationship with my dad. Oh, that got dark quick. But yeah, I know that I joke that that Orin is a Tidus isn't a dad. That Jack is a terrible father. He's not bad. He's just not the best. He's not dad of the year, and he'd never be dad of the year. He reminds me a lot of my dad. Which is weird. Except Jack has a better haircut. But anyway, you guys, that's going to be it for this video. My name is Miss Scarlet Tanager, and I have been playing some Final Fantasy X. I'll see you all in the next video.